Hey, what's up YouTube? It's EJ from mypathtoself.com here. Walking through my old elementary school right now. It's kind of weird. I haven't been here in a while. It's been, what, at least, I think 2001 is when I was in sixth grade. So that was the last year I actually went to class here. So 15 years, Jesus. Oh my, wow, that surprises even me. But, you know, I'm walking through here. I'm actually headed over to a friend's house right now. And, you know, I've been thinking about it a little bit today. I actually trimmed my hair. Not sure if you can notice. It's not being really obedient with me right now. But that's besides the point. Anyways, thinking back to when I was in, I believe, sixth grade. Sixth grade is when I decided, you know, I'm a nerdy kid. I'm not one of the popular kids. I don't like being a nerdy kid. I want to have some more friends. And, you know, I want my voice to be heard a little bit more than just the kid, than just by the kids that like play RPGs and Final Fantasy all day. You know, I want people to know who I am, and I want people to recognize me, you know? So I saw this movie. I mean, this is kind of lame. It's probably going to sound kind of lame, but the concept still holds true. I saw this movie. It was called The New Guy. It had, DJ Qualls in it. He was the main person in the movie. If you've seen it before, it's a funny movie, you know, but if you haven't seen it, you should go see it because it's kind of cool. Anyways, this kid is a nerdy kid at his school, right? And he decides that he doesn't like being a nerdy kid and he wants to, again, be recognized, be a popular kid. So he decides to reinvent himself. He goes to a different school. He gets kicked out of his old school. He does something ridiculous. I don't remember what exactly it was, but does something ridiculous, gets kicked out of school, goes to this new school, decides to be called something different, changes his name kind of, you know, and changes his haircut, changes everything about him to where he's not even someone that you can recognize. If you knew him before, you can't recognize him, right? And he goes to this new school. He becomes like the most popular kid on campus. And I mean, that's the basis for the movie. You know, a lot more stuff happens. But anyways, so I saw this movie, I decided I want to try that. So, you know, my first name is Evan. I've been going by EJ since sixth grade. Since I saw the movie, I started getting called that. I started telling people to call me that, my family, my friends, everything. I started hanging out with a different crowd. I stopped being a straight A student, which is probably not the best move on my part, but, you know, I started focusing more on being on the school basketball team and hanging out with other kids and stuff like that. Went into junior high, got in a lot of trouble, got put in homeschool, fell back into like this depressed state of not having as many friends as I wanted to. And you know, it really bugged me. But anyway, so I continued going by EJ and I was just this different person, right? So what I'm getting at here is that, you know, reinventing yourself is something that is very powerful. It can change who you are, literally. How you see yourself is how the world perceives you. At least, you know, once the belief is so strong, like at least when you believe it, you have the conviction in it that this is who you are, people start seeing you from that lens. You know, maybe it takes a little longer for people that know you already, but new people start seeing you in this way. What is truth? What is reality? It's, you know, the consensus of everyone that is involved in perceiving what it is that you're observing, you know? So if you can convince yourself, you can convince the people around you, your family, your friends, that you are this type of person, whatever that type of person that you want to be seen as is, then you can change reality in that sense. You know, you can be seen as something that you weren't initially. And what is what you are? What you are is a culmination of all of the experiences, all of the actions, all of the thoughts, everything that you've taken, everything that's a part of your life, that is what reality is. That's what the world's perception of you is, right? So you can change it, you know, make sure that it's what you really want, you know, because it can end up in a bad way, which is kind of what it did. You know, I wasn't in sixth grade, I wasn't quite sure what I wanted to be or who I wanted to be. So I didn't pick necessarily the right things. I focused on popularity and having friends, not necessarily the right ones. Popularity is not always a good thing, you know, but it did work. You know, you can reinvent yourself. And if you watch some of my older videos, like a couple months ago, had a different haircut, talked differently, walked differently. I was a different person a couple months ago. So I'm in process of reinventing myself again. You know, so many famous people, celebrities have done this as well. You know, like Madonna is just the first one that pops up in my head, but the media, I mean, this is on a grander scale, but the media focuses on big changes of people. You know, if you look at, like, I don't want to compare myself to a bunch of female pop stars, but Britney Spears, when she, what was it, she got married or she had a kid or something, you know, the media focused on that. It was a change. So keep changing, keep evolving. You know, you're a chameleon. You know, become what you want to become. And when you realize the things that you thought about wrong to become that person, change them, fix it. You can do it. You know, I'm doing it right now. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. It is now day 8 of my 7-day challenge, but I don't know, I'm pretty on point today, I feel. So hope you guys enjoyed it. I will talk to you later. Don't forget to subscribe if you have not done so already. And yeah, I will see you guys later.